Hello viewers, my name is Hilary Saira, the youngest sports analyst, and I'm your host for the Full-Time Whistle, a sports show that will be airing here on Faraja TV every Friday. And in this show, we are going to be presenting to you sports news from different sports activities in the world. Let's start with the stories that have made headlines this week. There was an event of giving away awards to different sportsmen in Uganda for their best performances in the month of August. As you know, the Real Stars Awards, it's a kind of... actually, those awards are given every month to players in different sports activities here in Uganda for their best performances. Starting with basketball, there's this guy, Ishmael Wainwright. That guy actually had a great performance during the Afrobasket Championships. He was representing the Silverbacks, that is the Uganda basketball team, in Kigali. That is where the competition or the game was. He beat his fellows who play with him on the same team, including Juko. Actually, he's called Juma Sayuko. Those guys are Uganda Silverbacks forwards. They play as forwards at the Uganda basketball team. But Ishmael Wainwright managed to come up with the award for his outstanding performance. Then the other category was in football. And in football, the award went to Muzamiru Mutyaba. Muzamiru Mutyaba is a midfielder at Express FC. He played very well last month. According to the Rio Stars Awards, he's the one that received that award. Muzamiru Mutyaba managed to score 3 goals. He helped his team to achieve the Sekafa Kagame Cup that was played in Tanzania. That game was in Dar es Salaam at Benjamin Mkapa Stadium. That is where the final game was played. And Muzamiru Mutyaba beat his fellows who play with him at the same club, at his club, that is Express FC, including Joel Mutakubwa. Joel Mutakubwa is their goalkeeper. Then another midfielder, Martin Chiza. All those players are very good, but Muzamiru Mutyaba was outstanding. So he's the one that received that accolade. Then another category was athletics. And of course, the golden boy, Joshua Cheptegei, managed to win that award. He was awarded because he won two major medals during the Olympics in Tokyo, the 2020 Olympics in Tokyo, Japan. He won the gold medal for 5,000 meter for men, 5,000 meter. Then he also became the second. He got the second position, winning the silver medal at the 10,000 meters. Still on the local scene. KCCA FC, they have promoted 2 new players from the junior team to the senior team. That is Ibrahim Juma and Mwanje Elvis Eddie. These 2 players have had a great performance during their under 17 or their junior academy teams, during their time at the junior academy teams at KCCA. Starting off with Mwanje Elvis Eddie, he's still a young player, of course, but he's so promising. I think that is why KCCA have managed to recruit him to the senior team. He joined the club in 2019. Yeah, that is 2019, from Masaka SS. That is his former school. He graduated at the KCCA Soccer Academy. Then he played during the 2019-2020 season in the FUFA Juniors League. That is where he was playing. That is Elvis Mwanje. Then his first game in the senior team at KCCA came in 2020 when KCCA were playing against Masindi. Masindi's Doves, Doves FC, you know Doves FC, during the Uganda Cup. That is when he made his first senior debut. But still, it wasn't a start. He just came off as a substitute. Now he has managed to be recruited to the team. I think it is a great achievement for him and Juma Ibrahim. Let's talk about the Uganda Cranes. The Uganda Cranes had two games last week. Actually, one game was this week on Monday, and then another game was last week. That is it. But all the games were Uganda Cranes didn't put up a great performance, to be honest. But I will not judge anyway. That is how they managed to perform. Coach Mitchell, his boys had two goalless draw games, actually. One against Mali and another one against Kenya. That puts Uganda Cranes in the third position in Group E of World Cup qualifiers here in Africa. Mali leads the table with 4 points. That means Uganda Cranes are 2 points below Mali. And then they are at level points with Kenya. Both have 2 points. Then Rwanda are the last in the group, and they have only 1 point. The next game will be, it is in October. That is when Uganda Cranes will be playing the next game of the World Cup qualifiers, and that game will be against Rwanda. Uganda will be going to Kigali to play against Rwanda. Then Mali will be playing Kenya, of course. That is Group E of the World Cup qualifying games here in Africa. In the international scene, Banang, there are very, very many big games, but the headline of this is Cristiano Ronaldo. Cristiano Ronaldo made his transfer from Juventus to Manchester United, and he's now a Manchester United player for the second time. That is where he started his, most people say that is where he started his biggest career. But he was at FC, before he was at Sporting Lisbon, before coming to Manchester United. Then he left the club in 2009, went to Real Madrid. After Real Madrid, he went to Juventus, now he's back at Manchester United. At Manchester United, they have a game on Saturday. That game is against Newcastle. And we expect Cristiano Ronaldo to make his debut. I don't know if the coach will play him or bring him as a substitute or start him. I don't know the kind of formation that the coach will bring. But maybe if we could predict, I think Cristiano Ronaldo would be the striker at Manchester United. Now, we don't know where Edison Cavani will be playing. We don't know where Mason Greenwood will be playing. But let's just wait and see what happens on Saturday. If he starts, then we don't expect Edison Cavani to start. Maybe if both start, we are going to see a 4-4-2 formation where Manchester United are playing two strikers, then Greenwood from the left, then maybe Bruno Fernandes or Pogba. Most times Pogba has been coming from the left, then Greenwood from the right. Let's just wait and see. Will he score his first goal at when he plays? Is he capable? So let's wait for the game against Newcastle between Manchester United. It is going to be at 5 p.m. In the evening, so wait for the game. Still talking about the Premier League. 5 p.m. still, there are very many games to watch. For the football lovers, you can watch Arsenal versus Norwich City. And that game is a must talk about game. First of all, Arsenal, the last at the Premier League table. They have no goals scored. They have played 3 games so far. They haven't scored any goal. They don't have any point. You see, it is a very, very challenging season for Mikel Arteta and the Arsenal fans out there, because this has never happened. Arsenal have never won 3 games at the start of a season without even scoring. So, but this time around it has happened. Their first game was against Brentford, they lost 2-0. Then the next game was against Chelsea, they lost 2-0. The next game was against Man City. They lost 5-0. So they have so far conceded 9 goals in 3 games. That is so bad for them. Anyway, they are playing against Norwich City, a team that hasn't scored, actually, that hasn't won a game too. But for them, they have managed to score at least a goal. So, Norwich City against Arsenal on Saturday at 5 p.m. For the Liverpool fans, the game is on Sunday at 6:30 p.m. And the game will be against Leeds. Liverpool will be, they're not playing at Anfield. They're actually going to be at the homes of Leeds United. Maybe we expect Liverpool to unveil their, actually to show up in their third kit, which they just unveiled of recent. But I don't really think, because you see the colors between Leeds put on white, Liverpool reds, maybe. We don't know. But let's just wait and see. So we have come to the end of our show. That's the sports news that we had for you today. Please don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Don't forget to follow us on Twitter at Faraja TV, Facebook, Instagram, and all the social media platforms that you can handle. My name is Hilary Saira, and I've been your host today. Thanks for watching.